Hello there, my crafty friends. It's Ashley Pfeiffer, the maker behind Stamped AF. I'm an independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator in Canada. And for this month, the Stamping Society is featuring mashups. I chose to use the Hats Off bundle because literally I have not even cracked this baby open. And if you've seen the last chance list, this is retiring. And I really have not used this very much at all. I've used the tag dies. I've also got some little scraps in there, but other than this one stamp, I haven't used that either. So I've got a cute little design kind of worked out here that I am going to put together with you. So if you would like all of the measurements and step-by-step instructions, you can purchase the tutorial. And for any of our team members get it for free. You can get it free with a qualifying purchase, or you can purchase it outright. So for all the measurements and everything you need, you will find it there. So I'm just putting a bit of a mat on here because I felt like the misty moonlight against this DSP was, it wasn't popping. So Night of Navy and misty moonlight, still not a huge pop, but I wanted this DSP, it kind of hurts to put this side down, but I had already decided on kind of a masculine card, so I am going with this DSP. Just need to trim it down a little bit. It feels like a shame to cut off any of the gold, but we're gonna. Maybe I'll stick with that side. So we'll use some seal. I like to use Stampin' Seal on DSP versus liquid glue because I don't like the look of those little glue worms that I get if I use liquid glue. So that's why I use DSP. And snail with DSP. Man, words are hard. So you can see this card is going to come together quite quickly. I use the coordinating DSP from Your Biggest Fan. All of the supplies will be listed in the tutorial. So I used that DSP, die cut one of the little tags, and I know you probably can't see it, but there's a little stitch detail on the top and bottom. And I thought that would be cute. From the Hats Off bundle, I've got the hat, of course, and I hope you can see the stitching in there. I used, again, one of the DSP from there. And then from that same bundle, I have die cut the little label for the hat. So I've got some of that DSP, some very vanilla. You can see that I'm using very vanilla on everything. And I will continue that on the inside. When I use very vanilla on the outside, I continue that theme throughout. I don't want whisper white, or sorry, I don't want basic white on the inside. So now that I've kind of decided I like it that way, I've just got to rejig this a little bit. This is just that one strip of tickets, and I love it. I love it. I think I might just stick with what I had before because it was all kind of worked out, right? What I would love to add is a little bit of that denim ribbon, but I feel like if I add anything else, it might be too much. But who else is thrilled that this ribbon is back? I can't really do a strip across there now because, of course, I've already adhered that down. Let's see. I mean, it doesn't have to be adhered down. It could just be loose across. But I'm kind of thinking maybe a little knot might be cute. A knot! So this is where the plan in my brain ended. I didn't go quite this far, but I'm thinking if we just kind of loop this around. I don't want a bow on a masculine card. It just doesn't work. If we do it as a little knot, I didn't give myself much room to work with here because I can't bear to waste a millimeter of this ribbon. I love it. Okay, that could do, right? Just trim those tails a little bit more. When trimming ribbon, I like to use scissors dedicated for ribbon. They don't even have to be good scissors. They just have to be dedicated to ribbon so that you don't have any adhesive. And personally, I like a longer blade so that I can go through it on one pass instead of something like the snips where I have to like snip my way across. Just a little tip as we go. Okay. I'm covering up the gold. I'm going to go with it. I'm sure once I sit back and look at it, I'll have so many other ideas. Has that ever happened to you? You see the finished product and you're like, oh, I could have done this, that, or 5 million other things, but no. Now, I don't love that this is so close to the background, but I love the texture in this. So I'm thinking I'm going to take my Knight of Navy and just go around the outside of this. And hopefully it will stand out just a little bit more on that background. I'm going to cut one more out of cardstock and then pop that up, because right now with DSP, it can be a little tricky to just pop that up with dimensionals. I don't want it to sag, so I'm just going to cut a piece. See, it's nice to have that little bit of color differentiation, but really I want to have that wood grain pattern on there. Maybe we'll bend it the way a hat would actually be. So let's add a couple of dimensionals just to give this some dimension. Obby, right? Can't have it all flat. Although I will say I have been doing a lot of flat cards lately. Cost of postage is insane. Okay, so we'll pop that up. Don't love that I can see that part. Covering up some more gold, but don't worry, we're going to put a little bit of that gold back on. So for this, I very rarely use seal for everything, but that is the way I'm doing it today. Now you do want to make sure this goes, I don't think there's a right or a wrong, but you want to make sure that they go the same way. I feel like the flatter one should be on the bottom. And there is a natural parting of the stitching up there. So I feel like that's probably where that's supposed to go. Now, I didn't realize, because I haven't used this set of dies yet, that this only does the stitching. I should have noticed, because there's no cut line on the outside. So what I did was I cut it with the coordinating die and then just trimmed it closer to those stitch lines so that I could see the yellow. I wanted to have a little bit of yellow on here to kind of bring together all of that gold. And because I did all of the die cutting ahead of time, I mean, this card is so fast. There's a little bit of die cutting, which totally worth it, right? And that's it. I kind of want to put another dimensional on this. I'm going to go for it. And the only reason I hesitate is because if I were to mail this, it would likely get flattened. It's got two levels of Stampin' Dimensionals, but look at the pop on that. So make such a great Father's Day card. Now, every time that I've used this, you're probably cringing, but every time I've used this die, I have roughed it up a little bit, maybe more than just a little bit. Let's kind of pop this one up too, just so it doesn't look like only the one, because I mean, these are tickets, right? To me, this is like a memorabilia thing. Like father and son went to a game and they kept their ticket stubs. We're doing like some memory keeping card making. So I'm going to use liquid glue for this, and I'll add a little bit on a couple of choice pieces. I feel like this kind of rustic torn look will also help that denim ribbon fit in. So it's not quite so, I don't know, foreign. Okay, so I think we'll put that one there. We'll pop that up. Maybe it doesn't need the denim. I mean, I love the idea of it, but I feel like I'm trying too hard to make it work. So this is just kind of a look into my creative process. So if you watched my most recent video, you know that I'm in a bit of a card making slump. So if that happens to you, try and keep it simple. Don't try and add extra pieces just because you think they might look good. you know what? I'm thinking it looks okay like this. I will add a little bit of gold somewhere. Okay, let's see, maybe a couple brushed metallic dots will help. I was going to add metallic pearls. I mean, a guy's card doesn't need a whole bunch of bling, but just to, again, reinforce that gold that we have scattered throughout. Let's use a couple of these. The pearls would have been a great size, but these are more masculine, right? Let's do one over here. One down here. And one. Always the thing, like, where do we put that third? Because you want to work in odd numbers, right? Let's put this one just up here somewhere. Good enough. Now, I did think about putting a little sentiment on there. There's a couple of great sentiments in either set. Like, I'm your number one fan. You're the best. You're amazing. But I thought something across there might be nice. But you know what? That's what I'm going to do. That is what I'm going to do. We'll add just a little bit of that. A little bit more grunge. It's feeling a little too clean. I mean, we've got some bending and tearing going on, so let's just add a little bit to these tags. Now, I would recommend doing this before you adhere it to your card, but this is how I roll. Carefully. If you don't have this bundle, you could always just use, you could add some splatter, but you do want to kind of move your stamp around so that you don't have the same like pattern all the way around. Speaking of which, let's add a little bit right there. Okay, I think that's good. Still feels a little open down there, but that's all right. I want the hat to kind of be the focus on that side. Okay, and then we've got our piece for the inside. If you're more comfortable doing your stamping before you adhere it, you feel free. It would be the wiser course of action, but that's not how I roll. I take my chances. If it doesn't work, I'll use dental floss to pull it up. But you know what? On the inside, we're going to put here's to the next adventure because we've got best day ever. So this is encouraging another adventure, right? So I'm just going to mount that on the other side of that. We can put a little bit of grunginess in here as well. I think I'll use Misty Moonlight for the grunge on the inside. We'll keep the sentiment as the focus. Now it's tricky trying to get it straight when you've got a stamp impairing your view, but lazy girl stamping. Okay, so some Misty Moonlight. I'll just put a couple of stamped off bits around here. I almost think that's enough. I'm gonna leave it. I can't tell you how many times I go and think, oh, let's do one more thing, and then it just, it may not ruin the card, but it takes something away from it. Like, let's just leave it as clean and simple. Okay, I'm going to leave well enough alone. I hope that you like that. The written instructions will be in the tutorial. And like I said, you can get that by being a team member of one of the 6 demonstrators on the Stamping Society. You can get it free with a qualifying purchase, or you can purchase it outright. So if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to reach out. That is what I'm here for. And we'll see you soon, my crafty friends. Bye.